Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of FM Charts for Tuesday, May 13th, 2014. In this morning's presentation, we're looking at three picks from Monday night's show, starting with Steve Grasso's recommendation to buy Potash. Now, looking at our charts, Potash is already up at the top of the range. We've recently had an early warning sell signal here. Currently ranked a 9 on a scale of 0 to 10, and so we would say that this trade is probably coming to an end. There might be a little bit more upside here if we can break out above 36.72, 37.50 is not only our next target on the daily charts, but it's also our target on the weekly charts. And if we look back to 2012 and early 2013, 37.50 was a major area of support. And of course, what was previously support will now act as resistance. So looking down on Tuesday, we would stay long Potash until we see a daily close below 35.80. If we close below 35.80, not only would we be sellers, but we would also sell this stock short. Next up, we're looking at Brian Kelly's recommendation to buy the Market Vectors Gold Miners ETF. And I've been wanting to buy gold stocks for a while now. We've found support right here. And unfortunately, we've made several attempts to move higher and all of them have failed so far. And now the pressure zone is getting a little elongated here. So we may have to go down before we can go up. We are finding support at 23.44, resistance just above 25. You can see our daily right side chart has given several buy signals over the past month, and we've had several failures here. So now we're back in the channel. A close on Tuesday above 24.25 would give us a short-term buy signal. More conservative investors might want to wait until we see a close above 25. And if we start closing above 25, that would start to break us out above the flypaper channel. Next up, we're looking at Guy Adami's recommendation to buy U.S. Steel. U.S. Steel is coming down to the bottom of the panic zones, currently ranked a 4 on a scale of 0 to 10. We usually like to see buy signals when we're ranked under 2. So we could still see lower prices here. You can see that we're projecting down just below $24 there. Mathematically speaking, if we break down below 25, then 23.44 is our next area of support. We are also finding support at the 200-day moving average right now, so a lot of people are watching that, probably one of the reasons that he's recommending the stock. On Tuesday, we're looking for a close above 26.13. That lower upper channel line will continue to move lower daily, but we would be buyers of this stock on a daily close on Tuesday above 26.13. Okay, folks, that's all for this morning's presentation. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.